Coke, Pepsi, and RC Cola are all cola products, yet each one tastes unique. That's because the flavors that define these iconic brands have been carefully crafted by food scientists. To do this, flavors combine dozens of individual compounds to create natural and artificial flavors, the proprietary additives that separate a Coke from a Pepsi from an RC Cola. Despite being a common ingredient in most commercial drink products, consumers and beverage brands alike sometimes struggle to understand what these additives are exactly. Let's say you want to create a ready-to-drink tea product with lemon flavoring. As stipulated by the United States FDA's Code of Federal Regulations, there are a few options that you can choose from for your lemon flavor: natural flavors, artificial flavors, or a combination of the two. Simply put, natural flavors are made with compounds derived from natural sources. So a natural lemon flavor can either be made with components that come directly from the named food, in this case, a lemon, or other natural sources containing the same elements. Citral, for example, is a compound found naturally in lemon peel, as well as lemongrass and lemon myrtle. But these aren't the only places you can get it. In fact, ask any flavorist and they will be able to tell you that the same compounds found in one source can also be found in a number of other sources, sometimes in much higher amounts or in more efficiently extractable forms. This is where artificial flavors start to make more sense. Artificial flavors can be understood similarly in that they are made with the same components you would find in any natural food. However, instead of coming from natural sources, these elements are synthetically derived from other raw materials. Remember that compound citral? Not only can you get it from natural sources like lemon peel, but it can also be processed from synthetic sources like petrochemicals. Now, that might sound scary at first, but it shouldn't, and here's why. Structurally, both the citral obtained from a lemon peel and that derived from petrochemicals are exactly alike. Your body can't tell the difference, and neither can your senses. That's also why flavorists often choose to combine compounds derived from both types of sources to create natural and artificial flavors. According to the CFR, natural and artificial flavors are classified differently depending on whether any amount of the compounds used are derived naturally from the named food or from other natural sources. Many modern drink flavors are achieved through a combination of natural and artificial flavors. Natural flavors are often used to establish the basic profile of a product, while artificial flavors are perfect for modifying and enhancing that profile. Together, they serve to support the product's overall flavor stability and quality as it sits on a shelf. Of course, the right type of flavor is the one that works best for your unique drink concept and business plan. To learn how Flavorman can help you change what the world is drinking, visit flavorman.com and stay in touch by following us on social media.